Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the for loop in the CODESYS in the structured text programming. Here I have one array of real values, one dimension, five elements that I have already declared. I have one variable which is called I of integer value, initialized by the zero, and I have another variable average which has a real value and it is initialized by zero. And now I'm going to calculate the average value for the array. So we have five real values and I will find the average value using a for loop here. I start by initializing or setting the initial value for the average variable to zero. So this is how we assign the value to the average. Then I start to write the for loop. It's by typing for I from 0 to 4. We have five elements. Then we do the for loop restart, and you can see that the end for appears automatically. What I want to do is to have average to be equal to the previous value of the average plus. Now I want to take the i's element of the array f. So I will type f, then in the brackets I need to type I, and then that's all. After the loop is done, I want to divide the average value. So average will be equal to average divided by the number of items, number of elements in the array, which is equal to 5. Okay, that's all. So at the end of the, if I run the program, actually, I will have the average value of the array inside the AVG variable. So let's save it and log in and run it to see what will be the value for the average. So if I run it, you can see that the value for the average is equal to 10.58. You can maybe verify it yourself if you wish. But here we can change the value and force the value again by F7 and Alt F7 to something that you wish. Okay, 7, Alt of 7. So I'm changing all of them to 10 to show you that the average will be equal to 10. Yeah? Here I will type 10, enter F7 and Alt of 7. 10, enter F7 and Alt of 7. And you can see that the average will become equal to 10. Okay, so that's all. So in this way, you see that you can use the for loop in this way. So you need to determine the for starting from an index for which you need to have a variable. Here I have used I, which is an integer variable. It should start from a given value to another given value, and you need to write this to here as well. Then you do whatever you want to do inside the loop, and then you need to have the end for to close the loop. Okay, that's all for this video. I hope you will like it, and thanks a lot again for watching.